Why did you choose chimpanzees? I didn't. I went to Africa with the goal of studying any animal to be out in the wild. If somebody had said a dormouse, I would have jumped at it if it was out in the wild somewhere. It was meeting Dr. Lewis Leakey, famous paleontologist, anthropologist, and he told me he'd been looking for 10 years for somebody to go and study chimpanzees in the wild. Nobody had. A couple of people had tried. It didn't work out. So how lucky. I was given the animal most like us, and B, I was the first person, so everything I saw was new and exciting. And then, of course, seeing chimpanzees using and making tools, that was the breakthrough. I think perhaps the most important things we could learn from chimpanzees is they're very good at reconciliation after conflict. We don't seem to be very good at that. We hold grudges, we fight wars, we have conflict all over the world today. So if we were a little bit better just making things up without continuing to fight about them or hold grudges. I was totally happy out in the forest with the chimpanzees, and I wanted to stay there forever. I mean, there was nothing to make me leave. But when I realized that chimpanzee numbers were dropping and forests were being destroyed, then I knew I had to leave what I loved to try and do something. I didn't know what to do. So my mission and my passion is to give people hope that if we get together soon, 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 we know what we should be doing to slow down climate change and loss of biodiversity, but we're continually up against vested interests of corporations and governments. We just have to be prepared to fight for what's right, not in a violent way. And so my passion doesn't come from anywhere except concern for the future.